Good evening, Dr. Ranjit Singh, sir, respected jury members, delegates, and all my dear participants. Myself, Dr. Neelkamal Bhatto, and today I am going to present before you on the topic Human Identification by Smile Analysis Photograph. As you all know, forensic odontology itself is a less explored part in India, and the technique of smile photograph analysis is at its blooming stage. The smile photograph that shows specific characteristics of each individual has found wide acceptance. This poster aims to study the various techniques. The very first is the scoring method, wherein each tooth is outlined and then matched with the tooth on deceased and scored 0 to 2. 0 for non-valuable portion, 1 for compatibility, and 2 for significant correspondence. The demerit is that the process of attributing score would involve a degree of subjectivity, that is, it would vary from one individual to other. Next, we come to the smile line method. The smile line is based on antemortem and postmortem photographs, highlighting the incisal outline from canine to canine of maxillary teeth. The two outlines are superimposed with layers of gradual transparency 0%, 25% to 100%. If they coincide, there are chances they belong to same individual. However, it has an indefinite method and not accurate and cannot be solely used for identification. Template method is usually used by orthodontists for smile correction. However, for odontologists, it may be used as reference template and the biometric measurements of each teeth can be recorded and studied. The sequence is tedious and it requires frontal view of antemortem photographs. Lastly, coming to the superimposition technique, here we superimpose the antemortem and postmortem images gradually by layering technique, increasing the transparency. However, even a slight change in magnification of either photographs may lead to discrepancy. But the discrepancies in each method can be resolved by combined use of multiple techniques. The advantage is that these tests are highly reliable, less expensive, and consume less time. Now, let's discuss a case of our esteemed forensic odontologist of India, Dr. Hemlata Pandey ma'am. On 20 June of 2018, there was a plane crash at Ghatkopar in Mumbai. The family members were in grief due to the sudden loss and demanded their loved ones at the earliest. As you can see in the photographs, the victims were charred. The identification was difficult and DNA testing would have required more time. The Mumbai police then turned towards ma'am and she identified the victims. There were 5 victims, of which 2 were females and 3 were males. One female, Myra Zuberi, was identified by her jewellery, and Surbhi Gupta, the maintenance engineer, was informed of having processes in her front teeth. On examination, due to trauma, the capping was lost and tooth was fractured due to its desiccation after root canal treatment. Pardeep Singh, pilot, family reported of him having a missing canal. Similar was seen in his smile photographs. Hence, he was identified. A passerby too died in the incident. He was identified by his brother due to his crooked nose. And lastly, Manish Pandey was recognized by superimposing his upper teeth alignment with his smile obtained from his Facebook profile. I would like to conclude by saying that, of course, there are limitations such as limited number of teeth visible in the photographs, low image quality, possibility of morphological changes in teeth after antemortem photograph was taken and during the incident, and difficulty in comparison due to orientation of photograph. But the fact cannot be denied that there exist variant dental features that can be potentially found in the anterior tooth. Hence, smile photograph can be considered as an adequate information source when the sample size can be determined, as in the above case study. The famous quote by Phyllis Diller, "Smile is a curve that can set everything straight." Therefore, it won't be wrong if we conclude by saying that unsolved cases can be solved by correct analysis of smile photographs. Thank you.